Happy morning to all dear students. This is your English teacher and I welcome you all dear students for your English period today. In the previous period students, we had done the YLE about unit number 5, right? We did about past tense, correct? We had focused upon the past tense, that is past simple and past continuous was the one, and I had also given you all the homework of past perfect tenses. So I hope that you all have done your homework. Okay, now I want in 5.2 students, one of the question was left, right? So we need to do that question. So we please open your textbooks to page number 37. Okay, take a pencil in your hand and an eraser and you will open your textbooks to page number 37. Yes, so our question number 5 was left. Now you see that this is the extract. This is the text which is there. Okay, now we are going to read this text. But what we have to do is, students, you can see that there are some incomplete blanks. Okay, so what you have to do is you need to complete those blanks by choosing the appropriate word from the box given over here. So we need to select the words from here in order to complete those blanks. So let us do it together. Yes. The gun pointed at my chest. Her hand seemed to be quite steady. They have given you the example, students. B. So this word B, let us check, is it there? Yes, it is there. So we have to choose the words as they are given from the bracket in order to complete the text. I laughed dash her. Let us see. I laughed at her. So you're going to put this word at over here in number 1. I laughed at her. I started to walk towards her. I saw her small finger tightened on dash trigger and grow white at the tip. So finger frightened on the, where is the, here. So you're going to write blank number 2 as the. I was about 6 feet away from her when when she started to shoot. The sound dash the gun. So let us see, the sound of the gun, and we have selected when. So you're going to cut this and then you're going to write it, so you will understand that which ones you have done and which one is pending. The sound of the gun made a sharp slap, a brittle crack in the sunlight. I didn't see any smoke. I stopped again, dash grinned at her. And grinned. So and is over here, yes. And. What's the meaning of grinned, students? Grinned means smiled at her, okay? She fired twice more, very quickly. I don't think dash of the shots. I don't think any of the shots. I don't think any of the shots would have missed. There were 5 in the little gun. She dash fired 4. 4, sorry. She had, H-A-D. She had fired 4. I rushed her. I didn't want the last one in my face. Dash, I swear. So, Okay. So I swear by one side. She gave it to me quite carefully, dash worried at all. So it is not worried at all. I straightened up. My, but you're cute, I said. Her hand dash holding the empty. Her hand was holding the empty. Was holding the empty gun and began to shake violently. The gun fell out of it. Her mouth began to shake. Then her whole face dash into pieces. Then her whole face went into pieces. Okay. So in the in your worksheets or in your revisions, there will be exercises like this, students, wherein the text will be given and you will be given the words from where you have to select and fill that the incomplete text. Now, open your textbooks to page number 38. We are going to do exam folder 3, question number 1. Okay. Now, students, over here you will see that for each question, that is A, B, C, D, you have, they have given you the hint, that is quantifiers, collocations, phrasal verbs, and so on. And so what you have to do is, you have to, you can see just below that you have the sentences. So you have to complete these sentences by choosing the quantifiers. Now they have just given you an example. It is not necessary, students, that the example which is given, like many, every, each, will be there or will be over here. No, they have just given you an example of you have to use quantifiers, quantity number. Okay. So, and I repeat one more time, it is not necessary that whatever words as the examples are given, that is the only one which will be suitable in the blank. No, they are just the hint for you all that what kind of vocabulary or what kind of grammatical term or verb you're going to use there in order to complete those sentences. So quickly take a pencil in your hand, students, and let us do this exercise together. So for the first one is about quantifiers. So there were only a dash people at the zoo yesterday. So there were only a few people, F-E-W. So you're going to write F-E-W, few. When we say few, it means numbers, that is smaller in number. Okay. Next is about collocations. I expect you to dash your promise to give me a lift. I expect you to keep your promise. Okay. Next, third one is determiners. I lived in the US for some years now. So it is the modals. You have to, Yes. You need to choose the modals over here in order to complete the plan. You absolutely dash not use this path through the valley. It's dangerous. You absolutely must not. Okay. Is the option over here given, students? No, they are just the example of how you have, they are the hints for you that you have to use a modal in that sentence. Now, verb forms. He's dash working on his car for 2 hours now. He's been, B-double-E-N, right? It's the verb form, no? He's been working. It's present perfect. Next, phrasal verb. Susie has taken dash photography. Susie has taken up photography. Okay. Next, pronouns. Tom hurt dash while playing football. He had to go to hospital. So he had to go to hospital. Matlab he himself have hurt. So Tom hurt himself. So the answer is himself. You will write it here because the blank is small. Relative pronoun. My wife dash who is Brazilian, works in the university. Now we have to do the comparison. Okay, quite easy for you all. You won't lose weight. Sorry, Suzanne has twice as dash clothes as I do. So Suzanne has twice as many clothes as I do. Now, next hint is linkers, that you have to complete the sentence by choosing the appropriate linker. You don't lose weight unless you go on a diet. And last one, students, we have to fill with the preposition. What is a preposition? Preposition describes the position of the noun. According to the website, all flights to Berlin are delayed this morning. Now, we have done with this. And question number 2 was your homework, for which I had displayed the answers in the previous video itself. Now, students, we are going to go through a new lesson. That is your unit number 6. So, open your textbooks to page number 40. Yes, so a new topic, 6.1, that is what if. Okay, we say na conditions. If you don't go to the school, I will not give you your food. Right? So, we are going to study something about conditions, but not now. Okay? Before that, we need to solve exercise 6.1. So, let us see the first question. If you suddenly become famous, how would you feel? What would be the advantages of achieving instant success? Would there be any drawbacks? Drawbacks means, would there be any problems? Now, students, this... So, I'm just discussing with you all. You may have your own opinion. So, you can just note it down. I'm not going to display the answer because it's just a discussion part. Now, according for me, if I suddenly become famous, I would feel really very happy. I would feel really very happy, and I would, you know, people would know me. They would, you know, take my interview, and I would be very famous, and I would have all the powers in my hand. Okay. And my drawback is, now since I'm going to become, I have become famous, or I will become famous in a very short time, it's going to affect my privacy. I cannot do anything in my related to my, you know, it's going to affect my privacy. I cannot have my own private life. Okay. Now for your students, it could be different. So whatever is your opinion, whatever is your thinking, students, you can just note it with the pencil over there on the top. I'm sorry. You can just note it over here on the top. Okay, now we need to go to this extract. Now, read the whole text again, paying attention to the highlighted parts around gaps 1 to 6. These give you content clues for the missing sentences. Now, students, such kind of exercises, such kind of questions we have done in the month of April, wherein the text is being given to you and there are some sentences which are removed from the text, from those texts in the middle. And what you have to do as students, when you all are reading the text, you have to read it very carefully. Okay, it's not just you're skimming the text and moving ahead. No, you have to read the text very carefully because you need to, because as I told you, there are 6 sentences which have been removed. And you have to tell students that which sentences are suiting to that particular incomplete number. Where see, you can see these gaps. Okay. So, you all are going to read the entire text, students. You all are going to pause this video. You all are going to read the entire text. And then on page number 41, you have question number 4, that is A to G are the text options. Now, from that A to G students over here on page number 40, see A to G. Okay. Now, students, from this they have told that you can use each sentence only once, and there is one extra sentence which is not needed by you all. It cannot fit in any of the gap. So once when you are selecting from 1 to 6, whichever is the correct sentence, automatically you will get that one odd man from that only. Now, I'm not going to read the entire text, but I'm going to read from where you're going to put the sentence. So, until recently, her greatest show business moment had been winning Euro 45 in the Undiscovered Youth Talent Contest in the small town of Stroud in Gloucestershire, close to her family home. But now, Mary Jess Leverland has found fame in China overnight, following her appearance in a regional television talent show there. So, this was the introduction, the first para that I have read for your students. Now we need to see that from this option, from A to G, which sentence is suitable over here so that it is completing or filling that gap. So let us see from 1 to G to A to G. It is the G1 students. She has also made her headlines back in the Britain. Indeed, thanks to YouTube, she's being talked about not just by her friends at home, but the whole world over, and has appeared in the television interviews to discuss her story. A 19-year-old exchange student won Jiangsu Province's equivalent to the X Factor showed by singing in the Mandarin. Okay, so it's about a 19-year-old exchange student has also won the singing. Now, over here, second one. Let us see from A to G students. It is the F. People keep on stopping the signing sensation in the street to ask her for autograph. You all do know, if you see some big superstar or any famous personality, you all must have some time or the other done that, you ask them for the autograph wherever they are. Correct. Next, third one. Min Xing Chang Fan Tian is a live competition on Chinese television, though it is a broadcast only in Jiangsu Province. Dash. From A to G, let us see. It is D1. However, it is no small scale event as the region has a population of 70 million. Now, students, you all have to read this text, because until and unless you won't read the text, you won't know that which sentence is removed from the text and that you have to select from the options given. So it is very, very important that when such kind of reading exercise is given to you all, you have to read the complete text. Now let's move to the fourth one, students. Fourth one is A. This was the song that had won her that original Best in Show title in Britain. Let's move to the fifth one. Dash, if I hadn't won, I wouldn't have been able to come home for Christmas because I wouldn't have been able to afford the flight, said Mary Jess, who has a 17-year-old sister, Jess. So let us see for the fifth one, students, from A to G. It is the B1. Although it fails into insignificance beside the amounts involved in the X Factor, the sum was still very welcome. So when you read, you will understand that which sentence is being removed from the text. According to Mary Jess, her singing talent is a part of family tradition. So let's see the sixth one. Which one it is, student? It is E1. See how you can even find the link. So when you read, as I read it now, according to Mary Jess, her singing talent is a part of family tradition. And your E option, it tells you what? Her grandmother was a semi-professional opera singer. So when you read, no, you get the clues and the hint. And based upon that, students, you all can choose the appropriate sentence in order to fill the gap. Now, let us move to question number 6. Oh, before that, a discussion question, fifth one. Would you have taken part in the competition? Why or why not? Any of the competition, have you, ma'am, almost all of your students, you all have taken the part in the competition. So why you all have taken the part? Because you have a talent for doing, you know that you can perform or you can complete that competition. You can win, you have the talent to do it. And that is why you participate. Okay, and why not you have participated? That also you have to specify. Now, we will move to question number 6. Again, we have the phrasal verbs with keep. Okay, so now let us do it together. Take a pencil in your hand. The verb keep occurs in many phrasal verbs as it's in the example from the article. Now you need to match the definitions A to F to the correct phrasal verb. One is used twice with different meanings. Now what they have said, students, these are the definitions of these phrasal verbs. These phrasal verbs are given in the box to you. You have to choose the phrasal verbs for its definition. And there are chances that you may use more than one at a time. More than one definition might have the same phrasal verb. So let us do it together. Stop the number, level or size of something from increasing. So what will be the phrasal verb? What it is? Keep down. Okay. You will write here besides keep down. Next. Make someone stay in hospital. So it is keep in. Okay. Keep in the, keep himself in the hospital, we say, no? So it is keep in. See, understand something that is changing very fast. So what is changing at a very fast? What is the phrasal verb for that, students? It is keep up with. We say, no, it is very important for you all to keep up with the new technology. To keep up means to, you should know that something is very fast and you have to keep yourself updated. So keep up with means to keep in touch, to keep updated. D1. Stay with something such as plan, subject or path. So it says you need to keep to. So the phrasal verb for D is keep to. Next, move at the same speed or someone or something. Okay. Again, as I told you, keep up with. That is, you should be according to the speed of someone. You should be updated according to someone or something. So it is keep up with. And last, not go somewhere or near something. So we say, no, keep away. So the phrasal verb over here is keep away, to keep yourself away from going close to someone or something. If you are not getting the space to write, students, please wait for me to display the answers and then you will write the correct answers and in the correct manner. Please do not make mistakes. Now, let us go to question number 7. Use a phrasal verb with keep in the correct tense to complete A to H, adding a pronoun if necessary. Now, students, again, we have to use these phrasal verbs of keep from here only. But now they have said, depending upon the sentence, you may change the form. You may change the form of the verb that is keep from this. You can change the form like kept in or keeping down. So you need to change the form of the verb or the form of the phrasal verb depending upon the sentence. So let us again do it, students. Professor Grant, first one, Professor Grant's lectures would be much shorter if he keeps to the point. Yahan par only keep tha, now we are adding s, that is keeps to the point. Next, second B1, if you all have not finished, students, you all can pause and then you can continue your video ahead. I rarely dash British news when I was in chill. So I rarely kept up with. Over here, students, it is keep up. So it now I'm changing the form, that is kept. Okay, for present I made a past of it, kept. So I rarely kept up with the British news when I was in child. Next, we really dash from the city center during the day as it's so crowded. So we really keep away, as I told you. Keep away means to keep yourself distant from someone or something or from some place. And crowded means, students, lot of people at one place. D1, Sally swims so fast and and never managed to keep up with her. Though she is swimming so very fast, but I'm not able to keep the speed with her. So it is keep up with her. So over here we are using the pronoun also, her. E1, Mark had the operation on Saturday, but they are dash for more tests. But they are keeping him in for more tests. Keeping him in. IN. Next, it's easy to get lost on the mountain, so make sure you dash the path. So make sure you keep to the part. Make sure that you are to that part level so that you don't get lost. G1, if Ben dash time at the meeting will be finished by 3. So if Ben keeps to time, keeps to matlab if he is giving that much of time only required, then only we will be able to finish by 3. So it is keeps to. And last, H1, students, it has 2 blanks now. My weight dash, my weight keeps on increasing. You all have heard saying my weight is increasing, my weight goes on increasing, my weight keeps on increasing. So it is keeps on increasing. I have to exercise to keep it down. Yes, keep down we had. So I'm changing it into keep it down. Okay. Now, question number 8 is going to be your homework, students, because we have done such kind of exercise previously. So you use the word given in capitals to form a word that fits in the numbered gap. Now, if you see this extract, students, for each blank, you have given the number. And when you see the options of the words from where you have to choose, so you have been given they have given you the hint that for number 1, this word will only be used. But now when we have to do this sort of exercise, students, it is not necessary that the hint words, how they are given, it will be used as they have been given. You may have to change the form of the word. Now, like the first one, the example is being given. Over here, the word is fascinate. So let us see how they have changed it. Why do we find celebrities so fascinating? If I would have used the word fascinate as it is, students, it wouldn't make any sense. Okay, it would not sound grammatically correct. So it is fascinating. So that way you're going to change the form of the words and you have to fill the numbered blanks given appropriately so that it should sound grammatically correct. So this is going to be your homework for today, students. And now I shall display the answers for the part that we have done today so that you all can get an idea of how you are supposed to write the answers. And in case if you all have missed out at some answers, students, when we were discussing, you all can make a note of it right now. I'm scrolling down, students. Yes, you all can scroll. I'm scrolling. You all can note the answers, pause the video, note the answers, and then move ahead. Here, see phrasal verbs of how I have written. Don't make a mess. Be very neat and clear in the work that you write, students, in your textbook. Because you, textbooks are something which wherein you are writing the answers and you all are going to study from there. So for all the subjects, do not make any mistakes or do not make any scratches or, you know, untidy work. Use an eraser wherever it is required. Yes, and the answers for this I'm not displaying now because you will not do it then. Okay, so in the next video when we meet, students, I'll be displaying the answers for this. And yes, till then, a small request for you all, students, to be at home and continue for your studies. And students, kindly upload your notes on the drive in the JPG format. And students, the assignments on the adjective which I had given you, the worksheet, which your parents have sent us sent me through the email. Those worksheets are not being uploaded onto your drive. Okay, so please do that so that I can give you all the marks. It contains marks. Okay, so kindly upload those worksheets onto the drive so that I can check and I can give you the marks. That's it for today, students. We'll meet again, and thank you so much.